Have you run into problems activating core isolation memory in Windows? We'll lead you through simple steps to troubleshoot and repair this problem. Core isolation is a critical security feature that protects Windows from malicious processes by isolating the execution in a virtual container. Memory integrity acts as a gatekeeper for core isolation. Its singular purpose is to prevent malicious code from attacking high-end security processes. So you've tried to implement memory integrity on your system, and you probably received this error with the Windows Defender here, going into device security settings and tried to turn on the memory integrity, and it told you it cannot do that. And more than likely, you had some incompatible drivers. So we'll close this down. And we'll add some Windows features as the first step to try and resolve the memory integrity problem. Now, we're going to go through a series of steps. And each of these may or may not solve your problem. So adding Windows features is the recommended first step. Turn on Windows features, open this up. And the two features we'll turn on is Virtual Machine Platform and Windows Hypervisor Platform. So we click these, and then we say OK. And once it's installed the files, it'll say restart or don't restart. We're not going to restart. We're going to go through each of these steps first. The next thing we'll do is check for a Windows update. Come down to the start. Go to Windows Update Settings, open this up, and see whether updating your system will resolve the memory integrity setting problem. Next, we will check directly with the company for any updated drivers. In my case, there was no updated drivers. They were the same as what was installed on the system. Now you could start Msconfig, because there may be some things running in the background that could cause that not to allow memory integrity to be checked. So we run system configuration as an administrator. We're going to say selective startup, don't load startup items, go to services, and then hide all the Microsoft services because we're going to disable everything else. We're going to apply that. Click OK, restart the system after we've done these things, and we'll come back down here, and sure enough, we still have the problem. Try to turn it on, and it says you cannot turn it on. Same problem. So we review the incompatible drivers, and the first thing I would recommend you do before you proceed further is check the security of these drivers to make sure there's nothing malicious in the browser. Search for the particular driver. And once I searched on that driver and made sure that it was a legitimate driver, I went into VirusTotal, opened the website, said choose the file, found the file on my system, selected it, and sure enough, it was okay, no security flags. And this is the name that was listed in the security integrity area, but this is the actual internal name of the driver. So it may be different from what's listed in your file system. And I checked on each of the three drivers. None of them were flagged with security concerns. So getting out of this, now we can go into the process of deleting the drivers. This is the last resort step. So if nothing else will resolve it for you, you will have to delete the drivers if you want to turn on memory integrity. You have to accept the fact that deleting these drivers could cause an incompatibility with particular hardware that you've installed on your system. So what you need to do is click on the driver, and this little arrow will appear, and drop it down, because what you're going to delete is this OEM INF file. And you want to do that for each of these, because that's what's going to be deleted from the system. So once you have the names of the drivers that you're going to delete, come over here to the Start menu, and you're going to run the Terminal app and type in the command pnputil, delete the driver and the name, And we did that, and it failed to delete the driver. And there's a good reason for that. Because when you come down here and you go to terminal app, you can see this little arrow here. It had rolled up the administrator function. So even though I'm logged in as an administrator on this account, you need to run terminal as an administrator. So once we do that and we run the command again, you can see that it deleted the driver successfully. So we clear the screen, put in the name of the next driver, run the command, and it deleted the driver. Put in the next driver, and the last driver has been deleted successfully. So we close the terminal window, and now we come back in here to core isolation, turn it on, and this time it says you have to restart the system. So it did turn it on. We restart the computer system. Come down to the Windows Defender, open it up. Under device security, we now have a green check mark by it. We go into the core isolation, and memory integrity is on. This concludes our video demonstration of core memory isolation troubleshooting and repair. Please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel. This supports our efforts in helping others with technology. Post any questions or comments below, and have a great and wonderful automation day.